Welcome to video 11 for the CCT Data Center course. In this video, we are going to describe Twinax and its connectors. In this video, we're going to talk about what Twinax is. We're going to go over Twinax specifications, and we're going to differentiate between active and passive mode, and we are going to talk about the difference between DACs and AOCs. So what is Twinax? Twinax is similar to the coax cable that you have for your cable modem. And its main distinction now is, if you think about what we talked about in the previous section where you piece together the fiber optic cables, you have the optic that goes into the Nexus switch, and then you have the connectors on the ends of the cables that have to match those of the optics, and then you have the cable itself. The whole idea behind Twinax is those three elements come pre-attached. So the optic modules, the fiber connectors, and the cables are all pre-assembled. So in a sense, it's kind of like using Ethernet in that you don't have to think about all of those components. They just come as one cable. Another thing to note about Twinax is that it comes in predetermined lengths. Now these are generally they're very much so shorter cables. These are meant to connect devices that are in the same data center, obviously, and very close to each other within the data center, with the max length of going up to only 10 meters. All right, so more on what is Twinax, active versus passive. So active means that there is electrical components needed to amplify the signal. And this goes for Twinax cables that are longer than 5 meters long. They have to have electrical components within the cable to amplify the signal to get it to deliver that same bandwidth and speed over the entire course of the cable. Now with passive, there's no electrical components doing that, and passive is generally for cables that are 5 meters and less. All right, so why does this matter? And the answer is electromagnetic interference. If you're in an environment that has a lot of EMI in it, you're probably gonna want passive cables. And the reason is that EMI has more of an effect on active cables. Passive cables that don't have any of those electrical components in there aren't as affected by EMI. Last, we have DACs versus AOCs. DACs are what we call Twinax cables, and AOC stands for active optic cables. It's basically the fiber optic version of the pre-assembled cables, and they can go longer distances than the Twinax ones. And here we just have a picture. So this is what these things look like. You can see that the modules are pre-connected to the cables. The one on the left is a Twinax cable. It's pretty short. And then you can see the active optical cable. Looks pretty much the same, except it has an orange wire and the fiber optic connectors are a little bit different, but that's what they look like. All right, that concludes this video on Twinax and its connectors. Again, we went over what is Twinax. We went through some Twinax specifications. We differentiated between active and passive, and we talked about DACs versus AOCs. If you found that helpful, please give it a like and subscribe, and I'll see everyone in the next one.